friends, I greet you all in the loving name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and I welcome you all to our channel Strengthening Souls for Christ. Well, I hope so you're waiting for video. In this video we are going to comprehend an eye-opening lesson, and this message is useful to every Christian, especially to those who are misusing and misunderstanding the love of God. And well, it happens in everyone's life, so that's the reason I just bring up this topic. And the topic is all about taking advantage of God's love is facing judgment. Let me repeat it again. Taking advantage of God's love is facing judgment. And 1 John chapter 4 verse 8 reveals that the God is love. It is not God has love, but God is love. He himself is love. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 shows that the characteristics of love. If we substitute God in the place of love and read the passage, we could fathom the deep gracious acts of God in the life of Israelites and also to his beloveds in their failure and disobedience. Yeah, God is loving us even in our sinful nature. He did not love because of our righteousness, because of his gracious heart. He is love in our weakness, disability, temptation, failure as we are experiencing in our day-to-day life. His love is unchangeable. He is so good in meeting all our needs. He is so faithful in fulfilling all the promises. He teaches to be strong in our difficulty. He shows his wrath for a moment, as we can see in Psalm number 103 verse 8. His patience is so great towards us because of his goodness, mercy, love and compassionate heart and unconditional love. Many of us are taking advantage of it, thinking that let us sin, no problem, God is there to forgive us. Christ's blood is there to sanctify us and purify us. Yes, of course, if you confess at the feet of God, definitely God will forgive you. And definitely God will forgive you because of his love. But we need to remember an eye-opening Bible verse, that Galatians chapter 7 verse 8. We know that whatever we sow, that only we are going to. By this verse, maybe you understand that. Now we are going to discuss about the consequence that we are going to face if we take advantage of God's love. God is a mother figure and also a father figure, means at one side he shows love, compassionate heart, and also in his grace we can see. But at one in other side, he is a righteous judge. Romans says that his judgment is righteous. He gives perfect justice in the same way. As is your father, he will give you perfect justice. As you do right now, that only you are going to reap. And I want you to turn with me to the Galatians chapter 6 verses 7. Let us read these words. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever one sows, that will he also reap. And man can easily deceive by his own thoughts and ideas. He deceives himself. And man should realize that God's love is righteous. Means, he loves you, but also he gives perfect justice for you as he is your father. As a mother, he will comfort you. As a father, he will give a perfect justice for you. I'm just bringing up a small illustration like that. And man have to teach to himself word clearly with the rod called Bible. Otherwise, we will become fools by our own thoughts. We need to understand the word clearly. Reading is not a matter, but how you are understanding it matters. Here we are going to discuss a Bible character who took an advantage of God's love and faced a judgment even though he was very close to God. I want to repeat the sentence again, that even though he was very close to God. If you have any guess, please comment it. And if your guess is right, he is David. If we talk about David, what will say? We'll say he was happy. Singer, dancer, fighter, musician, moreover his God anointed one. He started worshipping Yahweh as a shepherd boy while tending the sheep. God noticed him and promoted him from pasture to the palace. And 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 18 shows the characteristics of David. In last sentence you could find that the Lord was with David. In the Bible, in the whole Bible, there is no king who was an apple of God, has like David. David has a special place in the sight of God. God loves David much. When you're reading Psalms of David, you could understand that the relationship between David and God. scripted in other side of David's life, David became insensitive to God's love. So he sinned against God, as we can see in 2 Samuel chapter 11. And also he cheated his own servant Uriah with a very cunning plan. Scriptures clearly mention that God displeased with David. You can see in 2 Samuel chapter 11 verses 27. Even David sinned against God, but God still loved David and forgiven him after his confession. We all know that. We can see in Psalm number 51, his confession prayer. Saying that, wow, sister Bilo, what a teaching. Then I will also do sin as like David and I will confess before God. God will forgive. Yes, of course he forgives you. But before you thinking like that, I want to remember a very important point. Here we need to focus. This is a heart of all this message. That is, even David sinned against God. God forgiven him, loved him, but he did not escape from the consequence of his sin. As we can see in 2 Samuel chapter 12 verses 14. We can see in 2 Samuel chapter 12 verse 14 that his firstborn was passed away. If you go on reading, we will find the story of Ammon and Tamar, the children of David. Ammon abused his own sister Tamar with a very cunning plan. When David heard the news, maybe he understood the pain which he did to Uriah. He faced consequence, my dear friends. He faced a lot of consequence. Cried before God. He fasted, but he faced the consequence of his sin. So, my dear sisters and brothers, don't blind yourself that God loves me. So, whatever I do, God allow me to do. Not like that. He will give you perfect justice. And maybe you are questioning that, Sister Beulah, if God loves me and God forgives me, then why I need to face consequence? Yes, of course, we need to face consequence because it will teach us from our mistakes to be perfect in our future. Consequence is not God is punishing us with angry, but it is disciplining us. My dear friends, don't deceive of any other false teachings that whatever you do, God will forgive you and you can continue. Not like that. He loves you, so He disciplining you. So don't in the love of God, be vigilant and watchful in your ways. Don't be foolish by any other thoughts and ideas. Take the help of Holy Spirit and read the Bible so that the word will be clear, so that the word and you may go into the right path. I hope you understand this message. If any of your friends and family members are in need of this message, please share it to them so that they may also increase in their spiritual life. And share with this channel. Please subscribe to it. And also, if you have anything to suggest, please comment it. And at last, thank you for watching.